Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now in this video, I will show you how you can detect any device type. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, in today's video, we are going to detect the device types. So you would know if we are using or the user is using iPhone SE or an iPhone 10 or iPhone 10R or iPad, or maybe if you are building a Mac app, then you could detect the Mac app type, but we are not going to talk about that, but it is in the GitHub repo. And yes, you guessed it, we are going to use an awesome GitHub repo here, and it is called a device. So let's jump right into the code. And as usual, we are going to start from scratch. And let's just create a new xcode project here. Let's create a new project and let it be a single view application. Is fine. A product name, let's say device type, and I will embed this into a navigation controller. It doesn't really matter. Make sure that you take a look at the playlist where I show you how you can create custom Xcode project templates, and you will be able to find this template to download onto your Xcode. So let's just choose here YouTube videos and today's date. I will create a Git repository on my Mac. Go ahead and click the link down below in the description to take a look at this finished project. So yeah, we are just going to build it out, but you will be able to take a look at the finished one. Okay, so what are we going to build out here? Well, I will create a simple example here, and let's say you want to add a label to your view controller, and that label has some text in it. And what if the text already fits on an iPhone XR, but it doesn't really fit on an iPhone SE because, well, the label's text is much too long. So we are going to build out that today, and we are going to fix that problem. So to easily constrain this label, I'm going to add tiny constraints. Go ahead and take a look at the playlist. I always use tiny constraints. It's a really cool GitHub repository. So go ahead and take a look at that, how to use tiny constraints in your project. So first off, let's close this project and install tiny constraints. And I will just simply open up terminal here and type in cd and a space, switch back to our folder finder here and drag and drop the root folder of the project. Hit return, type in pod in it to create a pod file. This is basic stuff pod, and let's just drag and drop our pod file into Xcode. And let's change the platform to iOS 12. I'm going to skip over these real fast because I am doing this all the time. So tiny constraints, and you should be fairly familiar what I'm doing right now. So pod install to install those pod files. Well, it is only one pod here, tiny constraints. Great. From now on, let's open up the Xcode workspace and work in that only. So let me just resize this. And quickly, let's add a label to our root view controller. And it will be a simple label, lazy var label. Sorry about that. Let me just type that incorrectly. It will be a UI label. And let's initialize it like so. So let label equals UI label, and let's return this label. Okay, and what I want to add here is some text. So label text equals, And let's add some lorem ipsum text here. Let's open up our browser here and lorem ipsum generator. And let's just simply copy some lorem ipsum here. I believe that will be enough for a one-liner. I will tweak that so it fits on the R10R simulator. So I just simply add that in. And now we just simply add this to our view. So view, add subview, label. I will just center. Well, I'm not going to center it because I do want to constrain it to the edges. So we are going to have a little more detailed constraining here. So label, and I will just edge this to the top and to the left and right, and I will give it a height. So label edges, or rather yet, we first need to import tiny constraints, and then we are able to have these functions. So edges to super view, to super view, and we are going to choose this one, insets, and so on. So insets is dot top, and I will give it a value of, let's say, 36 plus right dot right 36. So we need to add that parentheses there. Dot, let's start with left and let it be of 12. Again, the parentheses, it is adding it. So let's add the plus now here and add parentheses and right. Okay, and let's add in here again 12 and add that final parentheses. Okay, so it is edging to the super view, and let's use our safe area, true. Okay, one last thing that we want to add is add a height for our label. Sorry about this parentheses, it's just a little weird. So label height, and it should be, let's say, 40. Okay, one thing before I build and run is that I will just add a background to our label so we may see a real nice red background where those edges are. Okay, so let's build and run and see how it goes. Make sure that you select iPhone XR from the list of the simulators here. Okay, and while we wait, let me just clean better this code. Okay, I'm just waiting for it, and there we go. Yes, it's kind of strange. Maybe I need to do the edging, not like so. Label top to super view, and I will have an offset of 36 using safe area. And now you know that there are a lot of ways that you could add any label or any UI view with the help of tiny constraints. So left to super view, and I will use here 12. And again, it was a good idea to add that red background to the label so we know that it is constrained correctly. So through here, and I will just simply copy this and delete the left and insert right here, and the offset will be minus 12. So let's build and run again and see if we did get all of that right. Okay, and there we go. Lorem ipsum dolor. And I will cut at the SCI. SCI. And hopefully that will be edging to all of the labels text. There we go. And maybe we should have our text alignment to be set to center. Okay, and that is it basically. Let's run now this on an iPhone SE. Okay, let's build and run. You will see that this text doesn't really fit into the label that we have just created. Let's just wait for that. But while it is loading, let me just drag this here. Oh yeah, and I forgot to add a white background to our view. View dot background color equals dot white. Okay, now let's build and run again, and we will have everything set up correctly. There we go. And as you can see, it doesn't really fit. But if we run on an iPhone XR, it fits. Just wait for both of them. There we go. This is our problem, and we are going to solve it today with the help of a device. So go ahead and take a look, open up a browser. So let's open up a tab and search for device. And I am using this from echo/device. You will be having the link in the description, but if you want to go ahead and type in github.com/echo with a K and two O's /device. And this is what we are going to use. So the installation is pretty straightforward. Pod device is what we need to add to our pod file. So let's open that up and type in pod device. Okay, let's switch to terminal and again, pod install is installing device, and I will just simply go ahead and open up again root view controller so we may go ahead and finish this project. Now, before we do that, let me just show you what this device GitHub repository can do for you. So there we go, our installation, and we can simply check for the device version. And if we go, just simply need to copy and paste this function into our app, but I won't do this because I'm going to use with an example. But if you just type in device.version and case iPhone 4, it will be printing out it's an iPhone 4. And as you can see, there's a lot of things going on here. And of course, you can have device screen size. So just access the size property of the device. And we have device type. And of course, we have Mac too, but we are not going to delve into that. And here we have some helpers. So, and this is what we are going to use. So if device size equals screen size dot screen 4 inch, then it is an iPhone SE. And what you should use, and maybe this is for another use case, is that it's not using just equals like equaling the device size to the screen 4 inch. It can use other parameters too, like bigger than or smaller than. So yeah, that is awesome from this repo. And of course, if you wanted to, you can also check if it is a Retina display. So we are going to use this device size equals size and screen 4 inch. So let's go back to our Xcode project. And what we are going to do is set, let's set the font size to be able to have this. Of course, you could use adjust, and I believe, let me just label dot adjust font size to fit with, but in some cases you want to, let's say, change the color or anything else that you want. So we are going to do it with device. So label dot font equals UI font, and we are going to use the system font of size, and I believe 16 is great. So let's just check it out on our iPhone XR if all of this fits into our screen. Yes, it does. And now let's just check if the device is indeed iPhone SE. So let's import, first of all, device. Import device. And now we are able to type in device and device dot size equals equals size dot and screen 4 inch. If this is true, then we are going to set the font size to be, let's say, 12. Otherwise, it will be 16. Again, this is a ternary operator you should be familiar with by now. Basically, it checks if this is true, and if it is true, then it uses this one for the first, and if it isn't, so if this is false, then it uses the second value that you enter. So yeah, if we are using an iPhone XR, then we are ready to go. Now let's build this on our iPhone SE. Okay, and let's show both of the simulators. There we go, 12 was real good choice for the font size because it really fit in. And that is how you can use the device GitHub repository. And it, believe me, this can save you a ton of time when you do want to develop for all screen sizes. And of course, you have other use cases, but this is the simplest one that I could show you to present this awesome GitHub repository called device. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos as they do come out. And I assure you, they do come out. Okay, now comment down below if you have a question, and as always, I will see you in the next one.